by DSI. This is Anurag Mishra, and we are in the course HSPF 200. In this course, we are going to look at different operations, purlin, impurlin, and retrace. And in this first video, HSPF 210, we'll look at the different hydrologic parameters for impervious land operation. For this, we'll look at a UCI file. So this UCI file is similar to the file that we worked on before. And we already looked at these blocks, run global files, operation sequence. So implant is a block that starts with the word implant and ends with end implant. And in this block, there are several individual tables. Activity, print info, binary info, general info. Activity, we looked at before, decides what processes are we going to simulate, what modules. iWater is a module. We already looked at print and binary info, so let's ignore that. General information, we have also looked at that. Here, the name that I have given, impervious land, when you're making a model that is bigger, that has far more land uses, it is always advisable to give descriptive name, and that is useful when you are getting the report of the model out. Now let's look at the parameters. The first is IWAT PALM1. When you later look at the PWAT, that is for pervious land, or HYDRA, that is for reach test, every time you will see that PALM1 is actually some set of flags. In this case, there are 5 flags, and they decide how the model is going to do certain processes or what variables are expected. So CSNO is related to snow modeling, when it expects that the snow simulation is also going on and the flow and the melt of snowpack is considered. RTOP is type of algorithm for surface runoff calculation. VRS. Whenever you will look at in the PALM1, some parameters with the letter starting V. V stands for variable. So these parameters will be provided a monthly value. So for example, it says VRS. That means the retention storage coefficient value will be provided monthly instead of a single value. VNN is manning roughness coefficient will be provided monthly. RTLI is when impervious land gets flow from a different operation. We'll ignore that for now. So having these values 0 or 1 decides whether we are going to whether that option is turned on or turned off. So that's what flag would mean. So VRS being 0, that means the retention storage coefficient constant value. VRS being 1 means the retention storage coefficient value will be provided monthly. IWAT PALM2, that is the second set of parameter. This table tells for each impervious land operation, what is the length of the overland flow, that is the length for which the flow occurs before it gets concentrated. And slope, manning roughness coefficient, and retention storage. If you remember from earlier, retention storage and manning roughness coefficient could be provided monthly as well. In that case, if this was 1, HSPF would expect a monthly table for these values. Moving on, we have another parameter table, IWAT PALM3. IWAT PALM3 is PET max, PET min. That means when the air temperature goes below 40 degree Fahrenheit, the potential evapotranspiration is reduced. And when it goes below 35 degree Fahrenheit, it is stopped. It is useful when you are doing snow simulation. It can control the amount of water loss to the atmosphere. Then state, you will see similar variable for IWAT state 1 and PWAT state 1. This tells the amount of water that is already in the watershed before we even start the model simulation process. So this is the water stored in retention storage, and this is the water that is in the surface runoff. When we are doing simulation of other constituents like sediments, solids, it's called solids in the impervious land, sediments, solids, or other water quality constituents, you will see that all of those constituents have some these kind of tables that sets up the initial values. Initial values are important when you are doing a short model simulation, anything less than 5-6 years, it's important to come up to it's important to come up with a good value for the initial values of parameters. If you are doing simulation that are decade long, these values may not matter much. We'll look at some more of these values in detail in when we go into the HSPF 300 course. And this is end implant is where the implant operation ends. So all of the parameters for implant were between perlent, between implant and end implant lines. When you're simulating solids or other water quality constituents, those tables will come before the end implant line. So if you have noticed here, we haven't mentioned anywhere what is the area of the impervious land. All of these processes are happening on a unit area of a impervious land. And later on, when we connect this impervious land to another operation, at that time we will assign an area to this operation. So with that information, we'll move on to the next video, that is HSPF 220, and there we'll talk about another operation called reachless, and we'll also connect an implant and a reachless operation. Thank you.